class called student, and we have three attributes: student name, string, age integer, level integer, and then a constructor called student. How many constructor I can create in a class? How many constructors I can create in class? Unlimited. How we have to change the parameters? The name always the same. Has to be student. Now this one we call it student. There is nothing inside. But I can create another one student or pass to with different parameters here. So it depends on the parameters. Okay. So we'll create one that requires some parameters. So public student again. This is constructor, yeah? And we'll pass the parameters. First one, string. We'll call it name lowercase. Second one, int. We'll call it age lowercase. Then int. And level lowercase. Okay? So, copy bracket, close bracket. So this is another constructor, which is the same name, but it requires different parameters. Notice here I use age lowercase, we'll make it uppercase, we'll make this one uppercase. Now when we get the data through the user, this is the parameters, eh? Passed to the user. How we store it? We store it this way. What should I say here? Student name. Equal what? Name. Exactly. So basically, the parameters I'm passing to the constructor will be used to set the attribute name. Okay? Same thing. Age uppercase equal this age. Sure. Whatever I pass there comes here. Level will be level. This is why I used uppercase and lowercase. Hazan, do you understand? Shabab, do you understand? I use here name lowercase, but here it's student name. So whatever the user will send here will be taken to receive this value. So student name, which is the attribute of the class or variable of the class, will be name which came from here. And same thing, age. Here, came from here, and was there. So, yes, let me take this one up a little bit, just you see. Yes.
What about the first public student? What's the boundary between the two parts?
Which one?
First one. Public student.
Public student. There are no parameters. This one, they call it default constructor. It doesn't
have. We have to put this and.
Yeah, it's a good practice to have it, right? Later we'll learn something called inheritance. When a class depends on another class.
Right. When we return something.
Inheritance is not a returning. Inheritance means classification. For example, I always use this example, cars. Okay? Say cars. Cars is a class. So many cars in that class. We have to speak about your car, which has specific unit number, specific model number, specific details. Your is object. So classes can inherit each other. You can say cars is general. Then we can say trucks. Trucks is a child of the main class car. We'll discuss those inheritance next week. I don't want you to be confused. Anyway. Now, so we have two constructors now. One is default need it wide, I'll show you later why this is important. And one that requires three parameters. We can create a third one that requires only two parameters, name and age. We can create one that requires only the name, and one that needs only the age. So it's unlimited. Why? That gives the user flexibility. If you want to create a student account, you know only the name, you can create it with the name. And then you can reset the age, you can reset the level. Okay? You give the user flexibility when you have all those multiple. But if you have one that requires all the three, then you cannot create until you have the three. You know, sometimes you want to create an application and say, no, no, bring all documents. You don't need to bring, maybe you can do it gradually. You submit what you have now, and later you can send to others through a different method. So multiple constructors gives flexibility to the users on supplying the data that they need. So we finished these two constructors. We need some methods. What are the type of methods we should use? We said setters and bidders. So what are the setters? Give me an example of one setter we can do here. Setters, what does the setter? Set the value. We call it setter because it's set. It sets the value. So if I want to set the name, I create a method called set name. If I want to set the age, I can create a method called set age. Okay. Getters, what it use for getter? Get the value, send it to the user. So the user can ask, give me the name of this student. And it will send the name. So you should start by get. And if you want to get the name, you say get name. You want age, get age. Okay, that's how it is. So let's create the setters. Show me you set, you do some. I'll do one for you, you do the remaining. Let's set the name first. So if I come here, one thing you notice here on the constructor. On the constructor, we didn't use void. Huh? Void. Void, you use it when you don't return any parameters. Okay? The constructor will never return anything. This is why it doesn't even use void. Even void is not required in the constructor. But in the method, we must use void or select the data type that method will return. Okay. Set usually doesn't return anything because it sets value. Get returns. Okay, so let's do that now. Let's set the name and get the name. This the two will do. So public void. Okay, set lowercase, name uppercase. That's the way you name it, yeah? And because you're setting the name, you need to supply the name. So you say string name. Okay? So this method now will make student name, this one, equal to name. Okay? That's a set method. Now, if I want a get method, it's public string now. Why string? Because it will send back to the user the name, and the name is string. So string get name, okay? And does it supply any parameters you don't need? Okay, so you just say return student name. Now we have one set, one get. You can do the remaining yourself. So the first set is setting the name, and it passes a string as the name. Use that name to set the actual name. And return nothing, because one. The get one, because it sends the user, it doesn't take any data, but it returns data using the keyword return. So it will return the student name. Now you can create set age, you can set get age, set level, get level. Do it yourself.
get the rubber liner? You see that I have it?
Yeah.
You fix it?
I scan bracket.
Now, after you create set and get, go to the main class, create an object of the student, pass the parameters to it, and use get name to get the value, set name to change the value, the name, and get the name to get the name. Practice these things. خلصت الباقي الكلاسات؟ Yes, Okay, let's think now. If you want to create object, what are the steps to create an object?
Constructor.
First, you need to say this object from what class. Okay? So it's from class student. So you need to say student with this capital. Okay? Then choose a name for that object. You can call it student one, you can call it S1, you can call it anything. Okay? Then equal, and then use the word new, and then after that you need to find which constructor you want to use. You have two constructors, one called student, one called student with parameters. Which you want to use? If you use student without parameters, just student or in close bracket, this will create an empty object. So that student will have no name, will have no level, will have no age. So we need to say. But if you use the other constructor, which is required to pass the name, to pass the age, to pass the level, then it will create an object with the name, level, and age. So the way to do it, first, from which class I want to create, you put the name of the class. Then you select any name for the object. Then equal, new, and then the constructor. The constructor is the same as the name of the class. That's how we do it. Okay, let's create it just to see how it works. Last time I'll create for you any object, Shabab, because you need to know how to do it. We will come to the main class and delete this line. Okay, we are now in the main class. Make it looks good. Now I need to create an object. I need to think which class. The class is student, is uppercase. Then what I want to call it, we'll call it S1. Equal new student. Now if I keep it like this, it will create an empty student. Has no name, no nothing. But if I choose the other one that passed the name, I'll call it Ahmed. The age will give him 15, level will say he is in grade, 10? Huh? So now we created a student, his name Ahmed, he is 15 years old, he is in grade 10. Now if I come here and say, give me Ahmed name, so how I do that one? If to get Ahmed name, I need to say s1.get name. Why I need S1?
Because Ahmed is
because the object, yeah, I need to know, to get the object. But this will not give me the anything useful. Why? Because get name it return a value, but it doesn't display it on the screen. So I need to add to this one system exactly dot out dot print line open bracket close bracket semicolon height kun barra. So this one now two lines, one line created the object S1, the other one display the name. So if we run this code, we should get Ahmed. And you see this Ahmed came, hello, Ahmed Ija. You know, we can make it a little bit better by adding here quotation name colon space plus كده بيطلع شوية أحسن بس الان هذا منين اجت. Okay, so this will look little bit better. Welcome name كل أحمد. Now if I want to get the age, how I do? It will not work. Why? Because I didn't create get age. But let's do it. Let's say I copy this one. I'll put it down here and change this one to age and say get age. I'll get an error because I didn't create get age in the main class. So I run it now. It will say to me, there is an error. Variable S1 of type student, it doesn't know. How I can fix it? I go to the class student here and create another method. I can say public shoot readly int get age like this semicolon and say return age uppercase semicolon. With this one now my code will work because there is now something called age. So you can see the answer came here. Ahmed is age 15. So I cannot call a function or a method that I didn't create because it's not there. Now if I want to get level, I go to the main, assume, or let's make the same mistake. The best thing in life, making mistake, because you learn from mistake. So don't worry if you make mistake. If you don't do mistake, you will never learn. Because how you do, you know if you're level, and we say get level here. Again, we run it, it'll say to us, get familiar with those errors, because if you understand the errors, you will be. See what it's saying here? It's pointing to get level and saying, oh, this one is unknown. How to fix it? We go to the class student and add the other method, public int get level, and that's it. And we return level. See level uppercase, I used uppercase because I'm using here the attribute. And if I run it again, things will become beautiful. That's it. So now we created all the get. What we're missing is the set. Assume I want to change the student name. Okay, I come to the main class. When is the main Adalium? Okay, in the main class, let us say S1, we want to change the name to something else. Who can Ahmed الآن من غير اسمه? Set name to Ibrahim. Now the name is Ibrahim. If I come after this one and I say copy and come here and say get name again, I will find that this person now start with the name Ahmed. Name Ahmed, age 15, level 10. Now the name changed to Ibrahim. Why change to Ibrahim? because I used this method, set name. I want to change his age. Faradan, I know we came after 1 year and he grew up and became set age. Okay, and we'll say the age is now 16. Okay, if I want to do this one, will it work? It will say wrong, it will not work, for of course, because I don't have a method called set age. So again, the same error coming. It came here, S1 set age, said there is an error here. And saying this is not variable, S1 of data student, there is issue with this one. Method age is not exist. See, this is saying, this is the issue. So what I need to go to my student class. Student, here is student. And we create public void, okay, because we're setting set age, and we'll pass the age like integer age lowercase, open bracket, close bracket, and here age uppercase, so will be equal to age lowercase. Now if I run my code, it will run with no issue, but it will not display the new age, yeah, because I just in the main function, what I did, I just basically gave a value to the age, but I didn't say display it. So if I come down here, take this one, which get the age from here, I come here and add it. Okay, now I have both. I run this one. It is here. Very good. So it started with Ahmed and this detail. Now we change it to Ibrahim. Then we added 16. So we are working with one student. Assume we want to create another student. We can come here, take this line, and add it down. My advice, don't take copy and paste. Write it. So student, we'll call him now S2. Equal. New student, and now we need to pass the parameters. We'll call him Zaid, and we'll assume he's 18 years old, and he is in university, year one, Al-Jama. For then he's in the university. So now we have Ibrahim came there. And we can use now set, get, do everything we need to do with Ibrahim. But one useful thing is to create a function or a method in the student. We call it get details. So public void, not get detail, display details. I'll just give it like this. So this method, when we call it, it gives us everything about that student. So it will display using system.out.println. What it will display? Name, colon, space, plus student name. Done. Then also it will display, let's not copy and paste, as we said, system.out.println, and we will display age, colon, space, plus age. Age uppercase, because I'm talking about the original attribute. Then system.out.println. Level plus level. خلاص. Now we have this nice method, yeah, which will make our life easy. If I go back to the main function, the main class, and I come here and say S1 dot display details. ليش ما طالع حلو كذا؟ display details open bracket close bracket semicolon. Now this is very nice one because when we run it, it will display all the details. Yeah, let's make it a little bit better. We go back to the student. Where is student? Let's add some lines before. So system dot out dot print ln. We'll add a line like this up there with semicolon. If you want, you can add a new line. This will add a new line, and then we add at the end another one, but there's no new line. How this will improve our code, if you'll see now. See, came هذا Ibrahim, because we displaying the second, we displaying S1, اللي هو أول واحد سميناه, not Zaid. But if I take this one and add it below this one, and now I'm calling S2, details. That's it. Now we'll have the details. This is how easy it is. I have the N, why I have this one here? A student, I think this N at the end I need to delete, so it doesn't look good. خلاص. This became very simple, isn't it, شباب?
Yeah.
Creating classes became easy. Creating object, passing parameters, calling set and get, it's easy. So do the other exercise if this one is easy. There's another question talking about product. You do the same thing, create product. And product already has a good name, has price, has a company or brand. Okay? So you can create this class for product and then create object of that product. Okay?
Two minutes.
كوبي هاي الكود اللي عملته تبع الباس ستودنت هذا هو الباس
ستودنت
كوبي هاي شوي كده بتظهر لك التصحيح كم درجة this one, video creates this one, okay, this one, new student, sides and create an integer. Because Git means you get confused with the names. The names has to follow certain. Because you're calling Git main here with lowercase and this is lowercase. You know, you're copying similar to my code with trying to call it. Ripple, use main. Here you need to have a class name. You can call it student project. Okay, let's go to create a project. Next, call it student project. Now create a new file here, file, not a project. Call it student class. Call it student with this handle. Now copy your other student here. Yeah, starting from this one, copy from public student. Public class student, you should have the word class. You can delete the public student. Now go to the main of your other project, copy the level 4 lines. Take them to that main. Now, if you run this one, it should work.
Did you submit
the program?
Okay. Like these people are listening to me. By the way, I will share with you this code. Where is the share? هذا شارع ملتون والله العظيم انا ضيعت
دكتور لو اركن اللينك نولوجي بروفايدد ويل ات كفر اول ذا توبكس
يس ات ويل كفر اول ذا توبكس يس دو ذا اوراكل وان بيكوز اي وونت يو دو ذا اوراكل سيرتيفيكيت از ويل اف يو كان ناو ذيس بروجكت هير فايل You want a student? Yeah, this is the student. Which one you want to see? Which part? The main class, sorry, okay. This is the main class. I'll put this one in the Invite, yeah, invite is the right one. Get the link, copy. Now I will put this one into our Teams. Teams. This is our group, sir. Let me copy. This is the rebel code. كل هذه الأشياء اللي هنا I can delete it if I want. You mean nothing. If I delete it and then run the code, see, we created student one, we created student two, and that's the result. Okay, so I will show you now we can create array object. Let's create array of object, Shabab. Remember we last time said we can use one variable. So I will create array list. Array list of type student. We'll call it students. We'll say new array list student. This is different way to create it. تكلمنا عن هالموضوع مرة الماضية. I'll repeat it now. Now we need to import array list. Where to import? Import java.utility.arrayList. Yeah, so we need to import it. That's how we import it. And then we'll say s equal, we'll say a student of type S. I will explain it again. So we'll say s dot student s equal new student name Ali and his this number عمره كبير هذا ما صار نسميها خلاص يلا خليها تمام يدرس دكتوره عند عند جريت وولف حرام الله خليه 16 يكون 16 is 1 and then we can say students dot add and we'll add s then we'll create another student سميه سلطان خالد سمينا وهو جريد 7 جريد 15 وجريد 11 وضفناه للستودنت. Did you understand what I'm doing now? Now, let me explain. Instead of creating S1, S2, S3, S4, okay, you will get tired, right? We created one variable called S. For every time we create S, we give it a name, age, and level. Then we add it to our storage, which the array list. See this array list? Array list like a storage that store all the objects. So you create a student and you put him in the array list. Then you create another student, you put him in the array list. They all use the S, yeah? You can add unlimited of the student. And then you can search the array list for those whose name Ahmed, those who is age more than 14 or more than 15. You can do all the search. In programming, you cannot continue creating S1, S2, S3. But we do it just for you to understand the logic. But the right way is to do it this way. You create an array list or array. The difference between array list and array. What do you think the difference between array and array list? Java has two things. One array list. You studied the Java before. Java,
yes. We studied the array.
Array. So what's the challenge with array? Until you studied Hazel Tanya. Or maybe you Java is different. In Java array, you need to specify from the beginning how many elements you have. You need 10, you'll say I'll create 10 elements in the array. And then later, if you want to add, extend it, you need to create another list, copy this list inside that one, and then add the additional number. It's complicated. But array list in Java, you don't need. You can add any numbers to it and remove any numbers to it to do. So the array list is more practical than the array. But it's good you learn the array. We will study the array list later, but from now knowing it is good for you. You become familiar with it. So basically what we did, we created an array list. It has a special way to create an array list. You need to have array list as a keyword, it has to be like that. Then less than and greater than, and between the class name, our class student will be here. Here you can come with any name. And I can usually use students, cards, things like that. So students here, any name. Now this one will be created from this time. Array list, student. In this one has a class after this. And once you create it, we create S. This is the only ones. Now we created S with Ali or whatever. We added to that students. Students is this one, the array list. So we added them to the students. We created another one. Okay, we need a bracket here. S, we added them to the same array list. And then we continue. Usually you have a loop here. You enter the name, address, and add it, enter address. When you end, you put zero or you put something, then you stop adding the data. And
and then after that you can have a search. The same thing we did last time. Okay.
Let me take the attendance even. Shabab, I want you to work hard.